Right, what's up YouTube? Welcome to ruffnutts TV out on the Yinlips YDPG16. Just want to show you what it looks like. There you go. There's all the cables coming out of it. I'm also going to demonstrate USB on the go, keyboard and mouse. So here it goes. Resolution ain't that brilliant, I wouldn't say, on the TV for PlayStation N64, but I'll show you anyway. First things first, you want to use this silly game manager. You want to load it up and then have it running in the background. Otherwise the buttons don't work. I think it's a silly setup, but we make do for that for now. What I tend to do to make this game faster is leave the frame limiter switched off. It's dead fast, but I love it. As you can see, it runs really fast, this game. Absolute brilliant. Love it. Oh, what have I done there? Oh, gone too far. So there you have it, that's PlayStation running on TV out on a G16, very good. Like I said, the graphics are not the greatest looking on the big TV, but it is PS1 after all. Right, let's show you USB on the go. As you can see, I've got it plugged in at the bottom. Wireless keyboard and mouse. I'll just leave that on the side, see if I can get this to pick up. Here we go. So, And there you have it, dingunity. So it's nice to use it just like a little personal PC on your TV, smart TV. Other game systems. Yeah, I posted in here earlier on, iShare Gifts have decided to give me a brand spanking new S601 because my shoulder button was broke. It's been a long time since I sent it and they're just dealing with it because they wasn't in to collect the post. So it's dragging, but as long as I get a new one, I don't care. So there you go, that's USB on the go function. Let's go home. And as you can see, it works very well, very responsive. I've not really got a lot on here at the moment. Grand Theft Auto don't seem to be working at all. I'm not sure why. And I think my set CPU's playing up as well. So yeah, all you need to do is get yourself an adapter. Female USB to mini USB, I do believe the adapter is. And that's for USB on the go, and then you've got this cable. I've obviously got an adapter going to a normal size HDMI, but you can get the cable without that adapter on it, which I'd recommend because it won't be hanging like my one is. So there you go. What else can I show you? That's it for now. I hope this video was useful to you to see how it works, and see you in the forums.